Now, if you could do all of these just by writing with a pen, wouldn't be in a computer class. So let's start modeling this. And so we're going to do our concept inventory. So what do we have? Well, these individual results here come from random variables. So a random variable is like the first child born, which can be a boy or a girl. The whole universe is called a sample space. And then these individual sets of circles are called events, like the event of having two boys, or the event of having at least one boy. And an event consists then of a collection of sample points. So sample point is BG, GB, or BB. In terms of representation, we're going to just represent sample points as strings. So we'll have like the string GG. And we can represent events two ways, as a collection of strings or as a predicate, a function which is true of certain strings and not of others. So here's what I did. I imported iterTools because we're going to need that. I searched for and found a new class called fractions within the fractions module, and there's a function or a constructor called fraction which produces an exact fraction. And the reason I wanted that is because when the answer is 1/3, I wanted to see that it was exactly 1/3. I didn't want to see that it's 0.33333. So all a fraction is a numerator and a denominator paired together, and they know how to do arithmetic. So here's my random variable. I represent that as a collection of possibilities, and here I just strung the possibilities together. I could have said set of B and G, or the list of B comma G, but I just put them together as a string. Then I said we can combine random variables with a Cartesian product, and I used iterTools product, and then I just said get all the results which iterTools product produces tuples, and I want to look at them as strings. And so now two kids is the product of two children, and we're looking at their sex. So if I evaluate that, I get this collection. And one boy is just the points in two kids that have at least one boy in the string. So it would be this one, and this one. And then I can define two boys as a predicate. That's saying that's true when the count of the number of boys is equal to two. That would be true here. And finally, I can define my conditional probability. That says, what's the probability of P given E, where E is an event specified as a list of sample points, all equiprobable, and predicate is a predicate that returns true or false of elements of that event. And so the true elements are just the ones for which it is true. And then I return a fraction, how many out of the event satisfy the predicate. Then I can ask, what's the conditional probability of two boys given one boy? And the answer is 1/3. So that's what we expected.